Hi everyone, welcome to another session of Payments on Developers Live. We were hoping to have a partner join us today, but unfortunately they couldn't make it, but they promised they will make it in a couple of weeks. We'll hold them to that. But nevertheless, we have so many things to talk about. You will definitely be entertained. We have announcements, we have some demos, and of course we'll take questions. First, we'd like to make an introduction. We have a new colleague. We were telling you that you were hiring, and we're very happy. We've made a great hire. And on my right side here, there is Nasir Khan, which is a new developer advocate. We're very happy to have you, Nasir. Tell us a little bit about yourself and what you'll be working on.
Thank you for the introduction, Mihai. I'll be focusing on the Volity API for mobile payments. I'm really excited to be here, and hello everyone. Hoping to see you in the near future for more of these sessions.
All right, we'll be counting on you. Tell us a little bit about the interview process. We've been telling people that we're hiring, and we have a pipeline of great candidates, and you know, you were one of the best. How was it?
Absolutely. So when I started out with the interview process, I was a little nervous because you hear and read these things online that it's a really excruciating process. It was intensive, I would say, but it was very interesting too at the same time. So it was very interesting day overall. I really liked it. It was pretty smooth and turned out well in the end.
Awesome, awesome. Yeah, we took it easier on you.
Thank you for that.
Just joking. You're really good. So we're very happy to have you here. And
how do you like Google so far?
It's been amazing, right? It's just been about a month now.
Yeah.
And there are, every day is a new day, literally, because there's so many things to learn, you know, and in fact, the payments area, of course, is so interesting, so diverse, and really, you know, moving ahead in various directions. So
yes.
It's very, very exciting to be here.
Yeah, so many cool. Exciting things happening.
Yeah.
Awesome. Well, welcome, Nasir, and
We're still hiring.
Yes.
So just enjoying the team as well.
And we'll see more of you in the upcoming weeks. All right, so let's move on to some announcements.
Yeah.
You've been traveling a lot.
I have been traveling. Yeah. I just got back from Kansas City. And what we were doing there was we were holding a Google for Entrepreneurs event in Kansas City where we kind of walk through the APIs and the products that we think can be beneficial to entrepreneurs, like entrepreneurs and developers. So I went there and I spoke about Google Wallet for Digital Goods and was telling them about a high-level overview of what Google Wallet is and how it can benefit developers and entrepreneurs selling digital goods. I also got to check out Google Fiber, which is something
All
that
right.
is...
Yes.
Yeah, totally amazing.
I envy you.
I mean, I watch a lot of TV, which is probably not the best thing, but I mean, I'm using Comcast right now, and the UI for Comcast, like Google Fiber, blows it away. It was amazing what you could do with using a 7-inch tablet as your remote control and being able to like schedule DVR and stuff.
Very nice.
And then stream the DVR content to the 7-inch tablet while you're watching TV, like some other channel on TV, was just an awesome experience. And totally excited for people in Kansas City. Giving
Very
you guys
nice.
A shout out.
Yeah, I heard that a lot of startups are popping up in the Kansas City area. Now
it seems like
Google
it. We
Fiber
had pretty good
there.
Attendance, yeah.
Wow, great.
Cool. Oh, one more thing. I want to talk a little bit about Stack Overflow. So we've now pretty much fully migrated from Google Groups over to Stack Overflow. And we're starting to see more and more questions about any Google Wallet topic on Stack Overflow. So if you have questions about Google Wallet APIs, such as checkout, Google Wallet for digital goods, Google Wallet for online commerce, Save to Wallet, or any of those APIs, you can post them in Stack Overflow and tag it with Google-Wallet, and then we pretty much check almost every day, and we'll try to answer as many of those questions as possible.
Yeah, so we're counting on the developer community. If someone misses a question, doesn't tag it correctly, please retag it. We'll be forever grateful.
Yep.
Okay, what else is going on? Some exciting new launches. Yeah, Nasir,
interesting.
You want to talk about
it? So as I said, I'll be working on the mobile payments.
Uh-huh.
There are two new exciting devices that have just come on the market. LG Nexus 4 and Samsung Nexus 10. They have Google Wallet pre-installed on them, and they also have the latest and greatest 4.2 Android.
Yes,
on them.
Awesome. 4.2.
4.2
yes.
is awesome.
I just
awesome.
Got the OTA this morning.
You did? Okay,
yeah.
Great. Yeah, it's rolling on.
Yeah,
right?
I haven't gotten to check it out yet. I heard the Nexus 4 sold out in something like 30 minutes.
30.
Yeah. I could be wrong. It might be like 50 minutes.
Yeah. No, it sold out pretty fast.
Yeah.
But there are more on the way.
I told them I'll pick one up too.
It's a very nice device.
Yeah, it looks
no
amazing.
Wonder. And it's a great price. Okay, so what else is going on? Oh, I also have an announcement.
Yeah.
So remember last time someone asked about open-ended subscriptions. So subscriptions with no expiration date. You just set the subscription, let it go, and either it will end when the customer cancels it or the merchant cancels it. So our engineering team went to work. Open-ended subscriptions are now available, and I'm going to switch to my screen and show you guys how you can set them up. So if my screen is on, you will see that we have a num recurrences field in the JWT. That is now optional. If you are not setting it, if you're omitting it, then the subscription will be open-ended and it will recur until canceled. And to show you how a screen will look like when a customer places an open-ended subscription, it will look just like this, and it will nicely say the subscription will occur every month, starting when, until you cancel a subscription. So that will mean it's open-ended. So for those who are looking for this new feature, it's there, go ahead and use it. And we were happy that we had such a fast turnaround. So with that said, let's see, any other announcements?
Pretty sweet.
We will have some interesting partners joining us, hopefully in the next few sessions.
In the next few sessions. We'll have Carbon Games bringing on AirMech, and then we'll have Kabam talking about their monetization and how they've monetized their games.
So don't miss the next few sessions.
Yep. Let's go to some questions.
Questions, yes, my favorite part of the session. So I'll take the first one. So the first one is, can we share revenue via the current or near future Google Wallet API? Is this a beta program? How can we sign up to test it? So that is a very good question, and it's coming up frequently. It is a valid business case and something that a lot of developers are looking forward to. Currently, there is no API that allows you to do revenue sharing, but it is on our to-do list. So we are working on it.
I'll take the second one. Okay. Any word on support for the Sprint Galaxy Note 2? So as you know, we can't like publicly give stuff out before it's announced here. But I would say to check the list of available devices in the help section on wallet.google.com. And it's at the bottom of the page. It's under eligible devices. And we should be supporting most of the Galaxy devices on Sprint. So
yeah, Sprint is
take
a
look.
Of our partners.
Maybe it's there already. I haven't looked at that page for a little bit. But if you're interested, go to wallet.google.com and then click eligible devices.
Upgrade to a Nexus 4.
Yeah, upgrade to Nexus 4 is an awesome phone. I played with it a little bit.
Yes. Okay, so let me take the next one. And this one, the question is, how can I pass user and order specific information in a Google Wallet transaction? It's not clear from the question if which Google Wallet API the developer is using here. So let's assume is the Digital Goods API, or also called the in-app payments API. With that, you have a field called seller data in the JWT, and you can pass any type of information in that field. It's nice if you encrypt it to make sure no one else can see it. And then that information will be mirrored back to you in the postback. So that's one way you can pass private information back and forth. If you're using the Google Checkout API, then you have a similar field in the cart XML, and that's called merchant private data. If you search for it, you'll find it in the documentation. Similarly passed in the cart XML, and you will get it back in the notification API. You will have to subscribe to the notification API.
Yep.
So very similar mechanisms and very useful.
Cool.
All right.
I'll take the next one. Is there any progress in getting Google Wallet on carriers such as AT&T, T-Mobile, et cetera? Again, can't really elaborate. I mean, I get all the questions where like, I can't say anything. Sorry, guys. but, you know, we're still working with them. I can't get any details. So I guess next question.
Yeah, I don't know if that's an easy question or a hard question. You know, it's easy to answer, but hard because we can't give more details.
Yeah, that sucks. Yeah. I wish we could.
We really wish we could.
Yeah, transparency is great.
Let me take the next one. The question is, how can I redirect the customer back to my site after a Google checkout transaction? So in Google checkout, there is no automatic redirect. There is a continue shopping URL field that you can specify, and that will appear as a link on the final order page. The customer will need to click on it to go back to your site. So it is not an automatic action. It is a user-initiated action. And this is one of the drawbacks of the checkout API. If, however, you are selling digital goods, definitely use the Google Wallet for Digital Goods API, because it's designed to be an all in-app API. So the customer never leaves your site. It all happens on your site. So you have complete control over the buy flow experience. So something to consider depending on what kind of goods you're selling.
Cool.
Next
what
question.
Is this recurring subscriptions?
Let me take this one because it's also about subscriptions.
All right, go
so
for it.
A little bit down my alley. So the question is, when testing recurring subscription in the sandbox, how can I verify that my subscription recurs on the correct date? Do I have to wait a month, as the only available frequency is monthly? So the nice thing about the sandbox is that you can do all kinds of testing and place order, cancel orders without really incurring any transaction costs. So to verify that a subscription recurs correctly, you could do a little, you can play a little bit with the JWT, and let's say you set up a free trial subscription that recurs one day in the future. So you set the first subscription charge to occur one day in the tomorrow. And then you just wait one day and you verify on your buyer account, did I get the transaction email? Then you look in the merchant account, did the transaction appear there? Can I cancel it? So it's not as bad as it looks with the monthly frequency. You just need to play a little bit with your JWT and get a little bit creative.
I have a question about subscriptions.
Go ahead.
Are we going to enable anything other than monthly soon?
Yes, we're gonna do that. Most likely weekly should be pretty easy to do.
Uh-huh.
And then 3 months, so quarterly should also be easy. We're looking at 6 months. So we're verifying, we're asking people which are the most useful ones, and then we'll go in that priority.
Okay.
Yeah, I have seen monthly and yearly too. There are some yearly subscriptions.
Yearly also. Subscription is also very popular, yes. So we're looking at all of those.
Cool.
Okay, you want to look at the next one?
Sure, I'll take this shipping one. So it looks like somebody is having trouble with checkout. And the question is, I have trouble shipping with checkout. I use product weight to calculate the shipping cost from the table in the merchant center. One item has flat rate shipping with product shipping class. When this item is in the cart, the customer is only charged a flat rate.
All right, we need a little time to parse this one.
Yeah, I think
it's
so.
Quite technical.
I did a lot of checkout support in the past, and then I'm like, in order to troubleshoot this issue, I would actually need the cart XML. That's like the clearest way to understand what's going wrong. But from this description and from like my experience troubleshooting shopping carts and checkout, I think what's going on is that the carts that are being submitted also include shipping information within the cart. So that shipping information is then overriding. It takes precedence over the merchant center configuration.
Yeah.
So if you've set up your shipping tables in the merchant center and you have, like, let's say you're using an e-commerce platform, and this e-commerce platform is generating some shipping information in the cart itself, that shipping information that's generated by the e-commerce platform will take precedence, and that's what checkout will use to charge a customer. And that could be what's happening here.
Most likely, yeah.
If it's not, if you're looking at the XML cart and it's not working that way, maybe try posting the question on Stack Overflow and then include your XML cart and include what you're seeing, like a description of what you're seeing, and then we'll try to take a look.
Yeah, definitely. We're going to be parsing also the Stack Overflow stream for more technical questions. Unfortunately, this is a moderator question, and you're limited as far as how much information you can put in there. So I can understand why this was hard to express what the problem is. So Stack Overflow with code samples, and we're gonna look at them, and maybe we can debug it live.
Yeah,
that will be fun.
debugging live.
Debugging Google debuggers live. Yes,
it's new. It's coming next quarter.
Okay, so looks like we're at the end of the questions.
Yeah.
Next couple of weeks are gonna be exciting.
Yeah, Thanksgiving next week. Gobble gobble.
But after that, another payments live session.
And yeah, definitely gonna do another payments live session. We'll have Airmec on, or so I don't know if you guys have heard of Airmec or played with Airmec at all. It is a kind of like a defense of the ancient style game. If you don't know that, it's kind of like a competitive tower defense game, and then. Basically, the reason why it's amazing is because of the technology that they've built and enabled in the browser. So we'll be showing this awesome-looking game in the browser, and then we'll be talking to them about how they've monetized the game, the method of like monetization, which in their case is freemium,
yeah.
Right? So we'll be discussing a little bit about the freemium methodology, and then if it's been successful for them,
yeah.
And maybe you'll find some insights.
Yeah, it's an excellent use case of how you can use the Digital Goods API to monetize
yep.
a browser app or any kind of game.
Cool.
All right. Well, thank you. And thank you, Nasir, for joining us.
Thank you.
We'll see everyone next time. Bye.
Yep. See ya.